Listen, just understand something, all right? Before we get started, I'm not exactly in the greatest mood today, all right? I'm not in the mood to dance around. I'm not in the mood to be sensitive toward your feelings. Like, chances are, if I don't stomp on somebody's toes, I plan on being an unhinged dick. Today, I'm not holding back, all right? So whatever come at this camera is just whatever's gonna come at this camera. Look, usually I'm a little bit more funny, ha-ha, which you'll still get some of that because that's just me as a nigga. But, you know, the part of me that just wants to be, like, kind and shit, nah, fuck it. So, y'all gonna get the dick with the balls on the table today. So, you know, just letting you know.
Oh, you motherfuckers. Okay. All right. I'm putting cases on all you bitches. Huh? You think you can do this shit? Jay! You think you can do this to me? You motherfuckers will be playing basketball in Pelican Bay when I get finished with you.
Mighty love dreams like...
Foolish thing. He said... Other than your relationship with God, who you choose to spend the rest of your life with is the single most important decision you will ever make. Because your other half will be your better half or make you half of what you could be. Wow. She will either inspire you to greatness or reduce you to mediocrity. Mm-hmm. And then at the end of it, he said,
Lord Jesus Christ. And let me go turn this game off real quick before I get started talking.
Give me a second. Technical difficulties. God damn it. Shit.
Sorry. Don't be wanting motherfuckers to hear Sonic the Hedgehog in the background. But. Steve Harvey. Let me just first give my take on Steve Harvey in general, all right? Steve Harvey to me sounds like a male version of what The View is, meaning like I kind of do and don't like Steve Harvey at the same time. Because to me, I got to turn his head around because this motherfucker beaming off that light. But tell me, right? Steve Harvey, and again, I told you already, I'm not holding back in this video. Steve Harvey, to me, says a lot of really safe-ass bullshit that I can't stand hearing. Like, Steve Harvey, to me, is like what Derrick Jackson would have been if he'd have transitioned and then, you know, became some other than like a podcast, you know what I mean? Which I don't like Derrick Jackson either because a lot of y'all ate that up. But I mean, far as like Steve Harvey, the guy himself, look. On one hand, I hate a lot of stuff he says, but on the other hand, I also understand why he says it. Steve Harvey can't go up there on that network that he has with all the women. Steve Harvey's audience is mostly women, all right? And you can't locker room talk to the majority of women. Some women you can locker room talk to, the majority of women you can't locker room talk to, all right? You can't say really harsh-ass truths to the majority of women, you know what I mean? So he has to say a lot of things that are in the space of, you know, like it's easier to digest, sounds good, makes girls feel good, all the other shit. Us, the rest of us on the internet don't got to give a flying fuck about none of that. So I'm kind of here to kick you motherfuckers back in.
I'm about to be on some real murder shit, eh? I'm telling you, man, any nigga that ever looked at me wrong owes me money or ever said any jealous bullshit about me is fucking dead. You understand what the fuck I'm saying? Hey, they're fucking dead, man.
Now, on the other side of that spectrum, look, there's a lot of truth to what he's saying in that clip. All right. Look, I've been married before. Okay. And I tried to let my negative experiences affect the future, but some shit just be bullshit. All right. Look, if you get a woman that is kind, caring, loving, respects you, everything, takes care of you, supports you and everything, That's a good woman, all right? And I will say this. As pissed as I am today, I cannot sit here and say that this girl didn't make me a better person. All right? She's helped me in ways that, you know, she's made me a more fit person. Like, she's helped me eat better. You know, she helped me. I'm not the friendliest person, so she's helped me become more friendly. You know what I mean? Like, she's helped me become a nicer person. I will say that, all right? Because sometimes the unhinged dickness can go a little too far. And, you know, the bad past experiences I've been through in my life, you know, the negatives, the ups and downs, the really fucked up stuff I've been through, it's made me real funny toward people. Like, meaning, like, I got to have been done knowing you for 6 months to even call you like a friend. You got to be consistent, all this other stuff. Because I'd have been shot at. I'd have had dudes, like, try to hurt me. I've had dudes try to sleep with the girls I was cool with. All type of stuff. And I'm telling you, the woman you choose to actually marry, for real, and take serious, makes a world of a difference. He's not lying about that. If you have a woman that is on bullshit, she can single-handedly unravel your life. Which really, that's the other problem I have with Steve Harvey sometimes, because he says a lot of stuff that's a little too safe. Look, I get the whole narrative of, you know, women are everything that he's saying, and I do get where he's coming from with that. And every, you know, for the most part, I do get it. Like, I do get it. He probably, you know, is real close to his mom and all the other shit. But with that being said, fuck what he talking about. Like, look, with women, right? The thing I've learned just over the years is you can't be too nice and you can't be too much of a dick. All right? And my mom and dad are a perfect example of that. Look, my mom was the kind of person that was a very kind person. She's very loving. She's very gentle. She's very understanding. I think that's where I get my understanding from. My mom is very accepting of people. She's very open-minded. You know what I mean? But I feel like looking back at it, she took way too much shit off my daddy. I love him like a motherfucker. I love my dad. I think he's a great person at heart. But with that being said, don't get too close to my daddy. My daddy is his own force of nature. He will suck you in and spit you right the fuck back out just based on the type of shit he's on. I'm just saying that from a person that has lived it, okay? You can't be too nice to women. I'm not trying to be a... Well, actually, yeah, today I am trying to be a jerk. The hell with it. Yeah, I'm actually trying to be a dick. You cannot be too nice to folks, because the thing about it is, when you too kind, folks take your kindness for weakness. They think that you're soft. They think you a pushover. Know what I mean? They take it as if like, oh, I could just get away with anything on them. Like, bro, there's certain parts of it when you deal with women for real that you got to be willing to stand your ground on and be ready to walk away on and be ready to lose and all the other stuff. You got to be willing to wage war with some of these chicks on some of this bullshit they be on. And that's just my take on that little part of it.
With this generation today, these young boys today, what do she bring to the table? The hell you mean, man? What do your ass bring to the table? You got a woman that can come to the table that can make another you. What else she need to slide up to the table with? What about your job? What happened to men who were supposed to be responsible? Do you know that it's our job to take care of a woman and some children, to have a family? That's our damn job. But what happened?
Now look. I'm going to just tell you what my thoughts on what I think. And yes, I'm hitting you with the knife hands. I don't care. I'm telling you, I promise you, I do not have that restraint today. I don't give a fuck if we fight. I don't even care if I get a strike today. I'm that mad. Anyway, right? When I hear people say things like, you know, what's wrong with this generation, or, you know, what does she bring to the table? Because I've seen a lot of girls get pissed off about that. And I am here to address your bitch ass concerns, okay? Look, whether you pay the bills or not, whether you pay half the bills or not, whether you don't pay any bills at all or not, you still need to understand, and again, this is why I partially hate Steve Harvey, because again, he says a lot of stuff that sound good on camera, don't make sense practically, all right? Look, I get the whole, like, what does she bring to the table, man, as far as the finance and everything, and you know, all that other good jazz. I feel him on that. And to some degree, I really do feel him on that.
I feel him on that. But you need to know what kind of person you're fucking with. Like, look, in life, over let's say you're married over the course of 20, 30 years, right? Shit's gonna happen. You, like, okay, this whole notion of, like, yeah, you're supposed to take care of everything. I would say, yeah, the majority of time. But people lose their jobs, folks get laid off, businesses crash. Like, and then, too, you know, wanting a man to pay all the bills. Look, again, I get it. I get the narrative. I understand what people are saying. And honestly, oh, my God, even with that, I don't care about it. I get the narratives that people are trying to paint.
But let me ask you this, right? Let's just be metaphorical for a second. How far are you going to run on one good leg? I'm not saying a woman got to pay bills in the house the same way a man do. I understand the argument. Really, I do get it. I do get where you motherfuckers are coming from. Legitimately, I say that with an honest, open, may not give a fuck right now heart. I do mean that. But you got to understand something. Things do happen, right? It might take your man a little bit to get back on his feet. Some, like, okay, personally to me, the way I look at shit, I can't be like, okay, let's say I break my leg. Let's not even say like I quit my job, lose my job. Let's say I break my leg and it takes 8 weeks for it to heal. All right. Can't do shit about it. Can't do shit about it. What the fuck are we going to do for 8 weeks if you're sitting there being like, oh, well, you're the man. You're supposed to pay for everything. Listen. If you put too much weight on a mule or too much, you know, weight on a horse that's pulling a carriage, that horse will eventually break the fuck down. Just that's my perspective on it. So when you say, what does she bring to the table? Maybe not so much financially, all right? But if you're paying for everything financially, you better be getting what you want on the other end. Because let me tell you something. This fighting in the real world shit, I got to go drive this truck tomorrow. I don't always feel like driving this truck. This truck can flip 6 times and I'd be damn near paralyzed from it. All right. Someone could break in this house, shoot me in my spine. All right. So what y'all saying? All that whole stuff about men bringing everything to the table. Well, what do women bring to the table? I'm not saying you got to be the strongest leg, but you better be ready to carry your weight a little bit just on the offset chance of something happening. All right. We're talking about the real world. We're not talking about all the celebrity shit y'all be on. These influencers that make money off of YouTube and all the other stuff. Because like I said, no matter how up, and even him, he's done been divorced and lost money. And Steve, that'd be the shit that really, again, gets me mad about Steve Harvey. Because he's been divorced before, so he knows. So it's like, when he sits there and kicks that rhetoric, and then the way he talked, in a sense, was like, I can see how he got taken advantage of. Because look. Again, you can't be a man that pours so much into a woman to the point where you forget to pour into yourself. All right. And that's my other half of the argument, because it's like, well, what happened to men being responsible and all this other stuff? Now, I feel him on that because I feel like I'm an honorable person. It's just me personally. I'm big on integrity. I'm big on honor. I'm big on following through on what I say. I don't say things to say it just to be saying it. I don't say things to say it just to be saying it. When I say something, I plan on living every bit of it. But with that being said, you got to have some sort of balance in your household. You know what I mean? And then these new women these days, whether you're put in a circumstance of being, you know, to be masculine and you have to, you know, you pretty much have to do what you got to do to make it in life. I get it. But understand something, because me and my girlfriend had this conversation the other day where it's like, well, if I post a picture, you know, if I feel confident about my body, all this other stuff, I get it from the woman's perspective. You just want to post a picture, but you got to understand something. There are certain things that men are repulsed by. And my response to her response was, okay, if you're going to post that picture, I'm not going to stop you, but don't get mad if I like every other girl that's on the same shit. And her response to my response was, I mean, you can post your pictures with your shirt off. I'm like, no, I'm telling you, I'm not crazy about you posting your pictures like that. Yada, yada. I'm not making this about that. I'm just making a point. But I'm not the craziest about you posting your pictures any kind of way. Da, 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 da. Just metaphorical conversation that we have. But with that being said, bro, these new women nowadays don't give a fuck about respecting a man. The majority. If you had to ask me what I think. Look, as pissed as I am today, I don't like the shit women are on these days. Because to me personally, it takes entirely too much work to get motherfuckers. It takes entirely too much shit to date people. Look, when you got to sit there and be on three different dating apps, you got to go to the bar when you don't feel like it. You got to set up dates. When you got to plan the entire shit by yourself, a girl's just expected to show up and be pretty. You know what I mean? And I understand why girls slightly deprived. They doll themselves up all the other bullshit. Not on that today. All right. When you got to go through all of that, because let me tell you, dating from the man perspective is a fuck ton of work. Like, when you got to go through all that to maybe get some pussy and maybe get some respect, that's when you run into the area where men are starting to push back against women and the things that they're saying. Like, if it didn't cost nothing to sleep with somebody or whatever the case may be, or if it wasn't such a job to get to the point to where you can't sleep with somebody, where you didn't have to do all this extra shit to get to that point, yeah, your argument would be a little bit more balanced. But see, the way things are nowadays, we have this constant power struggle on both sides from women that don't feel like they're getting what they want and men that ain't feeling like they're getting what they want. And it's making it to the point that, you know, things are very disconnected with one another. Like, men and women in general these days do not see eye to eye for shit. It's very few. Marriages are not lasting as long. And damn, I am on a tear. That's how I know I'm mad. Marriages are not lasting as long. You know what I mean? Because no one feels like they got to put up with anybody's shit. Look, you can't sit there and ask men to be responsible on one end in a majority and have women on the other end not give a fuck about shit on the other end, and then vice versa. Like, because there's things women say they want from men. Look, me and my girlfriend Sia watch a lot of shows. A lot of these dudes on this TV be doing some real fuck shit. Like, a lot of these dudes on these shows that we watch do real bullshit, and I don't condone none of it. But no, when it comes to arguing and just how you feel about it and, you know, paying all the bills, that's a very select, small margin of women, in my personal belief, and I don't care if you get mad, that actually deserve that type of treatment.
What happens to the, when the woman tell you, I don't need a man, Steve?
Well, they need to, what? Okay, if you don't, how that's working? You know, how that's working. Who don't need no man?
I'm independent. I can do for myself.
Yeah, but why do you want to? Yeah, okay, you can drop a transmission. You can sandblast your house. But hell, do you want to?
No.
I'm not trying to reduce a woman to nothing else. Be all you can be. But damn, who don't need a man? That's a lie. What man don't need a woman? I tell you what. Try to live without him. Try to live your life without women. This ain't about la-da-da, man. This is some bullshit without women. If it wasn't for women.
Now, far as the independent woman thing, right? And far as a man not needing a woman, right? I'm going to smoke y'all boots real quick because I'm telling you, my homeboy hits me up about this shit at least 4 or 5 times a week about this shit. Independent women, men don't need women. Women don't need men. Dog, listen. On this one, like I said, I have a love hate for Steve Harvey, but when he nails it, he nails it. Look, you can be the toughest nigga in the world. You can be the strongest man, bench press 300, crank 15 hours 6 days a week. That plate in the fridge hit different after a long work day. Look, I will say, like around, like, our apartment house, right? She's got the couches, she got the cabinet, she got the decoration on the wall, the big TV, the food in the fridge. Look, man, you can sit there and be a selfish rat bastard all you want to. And just, I'm just telling you from this person as a dude that ran the streets as much as you can run it. Them hoes ain't gonna cook you no fucking food at the end of the day, unless you get a bitch that like to cook. But majority of women that you meet in the street don't really give a damn if you live or die. Like, they care on a human level. But, like, if something happened to you, it's going to be, damn, that's crazy. I was just talking to him the other day. Da-da-da. Look, when you got a motherfucker that care about you in the household, that care hits differently. All right? When a person, it's a difference between a girl cooking you a plate because she want to fuck you and a girl cooking you a plate because she just wants to make sure you're fed. That's a different type of love. That, look, there have been days... I've been livid at my girlfriend, and I'm mad now. But that plate in the fridge, no matter how mad I am, God damn it, I don't care how tough I am, Southeast Georgia, real street nigga, don't give a fuck about nobody, you know what I mean? Came to the club just to fight. That plate in the fridge about squash all that. Like, I can be living at this girl, mad at her, screw that, I don't need nobody for nothing, you know what I mean? A motherfucker cook for you, look out for you. And you gotta understand something. When you get someone that hug, like, the love and softness that a woman comes with, men need that. Because the world is hard, bro. Imagine you just, you crank a whole hard work week, you come home, and then you just in this bitch and you gotta microwave noodles. Just personally, me, that was a life I got tired of. You know what I mean? That was a life I got tired of. I mean, again, running around, I get it because I've done it, but just look, when you get a motherfucker that care about you, it really resonates and sits different.
These hoodlums? No. I said, are we afraid of these terrorists?
Head got it.
I'm just saying, sometimes you gotta let a nigga know how you really, really, really feel.
Lick, man, but these young boys done forgot it because these women out here, they trying to be, they've had to be independent because right. They ain't got the right man.
Okay.
But this system of marriage is still good.
Okay.
This system of a man taking care of a woman, that's really how it's supposed to be. All the rest of it's bullshit, man. And y'all need to quit tricking yourself with this new way of thinking. Because there's no way to think. This new way of thinking ain't getting y'all no damn where. I'm sorry.
Now, as far as this part, right? Having to be independent because they ain't got the right man. There's some truth to that. All right? Because I've watched my mother do that firsthand. He's not wrong. As much as I want to talk shit about it because I'm being a dick today. But he's not wrong. He's not saying anything wrong. He's not saying anything like stupid. You know what I mean? He is on the right track with that. You know, look, if you had to ask me why I think it, I think life has put us all in the position to where we've been pitted against each other. Meaning like dating has become really toxic. So everybody's on defense while at the same time playing offense. As far as being independent, I mean, women need to be independent because look, as much shit as I talk, there are some really fucked up men in the world, for real, that really do beat on women, assault them, and you know, like, leave them for dead. There are men really like that. So, I mean, as a woman, I'm not saying me. You get it. Look, as a woman, right, you do need to have some sort of legs up under you, just in case a motherfucker abandon your ass and you need to be able to take care of the shit myself. Like, not myself, yourself. Look, when I look back at it, if I had to go back to my childhood, there were times when my dad left. You know what I mean? For whatever reason. I remember one time specifically was like I graduated. He brought me this big blue truck and I never forget it because it's one of the things that led to us having like a 2-year fallout. He brought this truck down. He put all the stuff on it, adding like rims, speaker systems, everything I didn't ask for. You know, I didn't ask for. I graduate, you know, a couple days later, him and my mom get into a fight. He take off and go to Virginia for like a year. Like, my daddy was just one of them kind of people. Like, if you pissed him off across them, he was out. Like, he deal with it by yourself. That was just what type of time he was on. My dad didn't give a damn. But on the other end of the spectrum, I do remember times where he did care. Like, I think if my dad wasn't around, I think I'd be less of a man, honestly. You know what I mean? There are principles and things I did get him that work that I, you know, things I got from him that were building blocks that helped me become a better person. You know, I can see him being, you know, one of them kind of guys that get even with people, like, especially when it comes to street beef. I remember one time wanting to shoot a motherfucker. And my dad told me, and I never forget this shit. He's like, man, one time I got so mad at the dude, I laid hitting his bushes for about 2 days with a rifle. And I sat out there for 2 days after a while. I got up and I just left and went on because I knew it wasn't going to be worth me going to jail behind. But as far as the, you know, the marriage system still being good, right? I think marriage is good if you had to ask me, right? Because me personally, I'm not, Like, most of my homeboys, most men that I know or speak to in this day and age, they're kind of, like, closed off to the marriage thing. Because you got to understand something. Men are kind of, like, proactive, not reactive, but a little bit reactive. We keep seeing these women get divorced and take half their shit and take the kids and the court ring these men. If you want to know why you're not getting a ring, it's not even so much. Part of it is your attitude and the way you act. Two, it's him maybe not liking you in that way. And three, he's done seen other men get pretty much, you know, rammed up the ass by the court system and just the shit that's going on in today's time. So it's like, I think the essence of marriage is good. I think the sticking with a person and, you know, being with them long term is a good thing. Personally, me, I've kind of always wanted it. But I didn't, you know, when I look back in the past and just the way I felt, I didn't trust anybody. I had really, really fucked up trust for people because a lot of people have crossed me and done things to me that I didn't feel like I deserved. Like, really ghetto ass people that just, I don't know, were just out for themselves, man. But I mean, again, this is my whole take on Steve Harvey, man. And it just was one of those things. I was going to have to sit down and take an hour or two to do it. I mean, this editing thing, it takes a lot of work and it takes a lot of energy putting in, you know, and I like to put in little jokes and everything. But, you know, I've had a bit of a day. I've been going through my own things. But, I mean, again, if you had to ask me how I feel, these are my thoughts on Steve Harvey. This is just me bringing down what I think. My homeboy sent me this shit, but I had the 3-minute clip already when he sent it to me. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to really, like, take my time and walk this whole thing down. So, with that being said, I'm probably going to go get me something to eat, and I'm going to chill out. Y'all have a good and blessed Sunday. Damn, I was supposed to tell y'all what day of the week it was. Fuck it.